Hello students, welcome to my next video, Business Research Process. I, Dr. Rohan Dahiwale, welcome you all. This is Business Research Methods online lecture series. Today is lecture number 7. In today's lecture, we will learn business research process. Learning questions for today's lecture: what is business research process and what are various steps in business research process? We will begin with the lecture. First of all, we will see what do you understand by business research process. Research process consists of a number of closely related activities with logical and sequential steps. Various steps involved in a business research process are not mutually exclusive, nor they are separate and distinct. Now we will see the business research process steps. The process of business research. A good research should follow the proper research process to achieve the best results. We will see each and every step one by one. The very first step is problem identification or opportunity identification. This step is followed by literature review. After that, formulating research question is the step. Then formulating research design, field work and data collection. After that, data analysis. Then data interpretation and finding out results and findings. And last step is management decisions and implementation. So these are various steps involved in the process of business research. Now we will learn each step one by one in detail. Very first step is problem identification. Step number one, problem or opportunity identification. Research process starts with the problem or opportunity identification. This step is similar to the formulation of research problem. Management of the company identifies the problem in the organization or opportunity in the existing environment. The representative of the management or decision makers discuss the dimensions of the problems with the researcher. Then researcher can suggest a probable solution to the decision maker, but decision makers takes the decision actually. So this is step number one, problem or opportunity identification. Once the problem is identified, now researcher can move towards step number two. The step number two is review of related literature, concepts and theories. So step two, literature review. Literature review is usually the longest stage in the research process. Actually, the research or literature research review starts even before the formulation of the research aims and objectives, because researcher have to check if exactly the same research has been addressed or similar type of problems or identification has been taken place before. That researcher needs to check. If the similar type of problem was there previously, then similar type of solutions will be there, and in that case there is no need to conduct a research. That's why a review of literature is extremely important, where we can directly get solution also. Yet the main part of literature review is conducted after the formulation of research aims and objective. Researcher has to use a wide range of secondary data sources, such as various reference books, newspapers, magazines, journals, online articles, etc. The literature review must be related to the area of the problem of the research to be conducted. So this is about step number two, review of literature. Now we will understand step number three, formulating research questions. So step number three, formulating of research questions. I have prepared a separate video on how to formulate research questions. You can check my previous videos. The researcher systematically explores the nature of the research problem and identifies the root cause of the problem. The researcher, with the help of secondary data and various theories, finds the probable reasons for the symptoms occurring. Management problem is concerned with the decision maker and is action oriented in nature. The research questions and investigation questions are formed in this text. How to convert management dilemma into research questions and investigation questions, I have explained in another video. A problem or opportunity never comes in isolation. Hence, the researcher has to thoroughly understand the background and then propose the probable reasons for the symptoms. So this is about formulating of research questions. Now we will move towards step number 4, that is formulating research design. The researcher designs the framework for conducting the research. It resembles plan for conducting a building. Research design directs the steps to be taken in conducting a particular research. There are different type of research designs like exploratory research design, experimental research design, descriptive research design, etc. I will prepare a separate video on research design soon. Research design should be flexible. It also contains the appropriate sample techniques, sample size, etc., and suitable data and data analysis plan. Proper research design will help researcher to achieve successful completion of this research work. So formulating research design is an important task and step number 4 in business research process. Next step is step number 5, field work and actual data collection. Under this step, data related to the research is collected. If the data is collected for the first time, then it is called as primary data. When already collected data is used by the researcher, then it is called as secondary data. Interviews, observations, surveys, filling up the questionnaires, schedules, etc. are the sources of primary data. Similarly, the sources of secondary data will be reports, journals, other publications like reference books, etc. So this is about fieldwork and data collection, where researcher has to actually collect the data from the field, maybe using primary data or using secondary data. Step number 6, performing data analysis. Collected data is pre-processed before analyzing. Primary data collected may contain outliers and missing values. The data processing and pre-processing, which includes data cleaning, integration, transformation, reduction of data, and codification of data. Data collected is analyzed through predetermined sophisticated software tools like percentage methods, averages, standard deviation, univariate statistical analysis, and multivariate statistical analysis, etc. So this is step number 6, performing data analysis. Step number 7, interpretation of results and findings. Researcher interprets the statistical results of the analysis. The hypothesis, if it is framed, then hypothesis testing is done. And the frame hypothesis is either accepted or rejected. So this is done in step number 7, interpretation of results and findings. Then step number 8, that is last step, is management decision and its implementation. The researcher communicates the finding and conclusions through a report to the management or to the decision makers. The decision makers take appropriate decisions based on the findings and results. So these are various steps in business research process. Now we will understand the iterative nature of business research process. A process of arriving at a decision or desired result by repeating rounds of analysis or cycle of operations. The objective is to bring the desired decision or result close to discovery with each repetition. These repetitions is called as iteration. The iterative process can be used where the decision is not exactly or easily recoverable, or where the sequences of recovery could be costly. We have seen the business research process so far. This process involves several steps like making observations, asking scientific questions, formulating a research hypothesis, testing the hypothesis, data analyzing, drawing conclusions, and communicating your results to the top management. These steps work best when you go through them in a particular order, that is sequential order. For example, it's difficult to ask management questions if you have not made any observations. You are also going to run the trouble if you are going to formulate the hypothesis without management questions in mind and without identifying depending and independent variables. So good luck analyzing data without any experiment to generate them. But why? The order of the steps are very important. This entire process is iterative and repeatable. Once you run your experiment and gather and analyze your data, you may have some new observations that will lead to some new questions. If this happens, you may decide to rerun the entire experiment, certain parts of it, or you may have to entirely do new experiment in your mind. So that's why these steps are logical and sequential, and there may be some iterations in the process. So this is the iterative nature of business research process. Learning outcomes from today's lecture. We have learned what is business research process and concept of business research process. We have also seen various steps in detail of business research process. What's next? In my next video, we will understand thoroughly what do you understand by research proposal and what are various elements in research proposal. Till then, keep thinking, keep learning, and keep watching my channel. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, comment, and turn on the bell icon for further notifications. All the best.